Good morning, boys and girls. My name is Teacher Anne again on your online lesson from Deliverance Church Umoja. I'm so happy to have you. It's going to be a brilliant lesson today. Please prepare your notebook and your biro. Call your friends. We are ready to roll. Before we start, shall we pray? The prayer position, please put your hands together, close your eyes, and bow your head. Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, you're almighty, you're all gracious, you're all wonderful, and we love you, Jehovah. Thank you, Lord, for a brilliant lesson that you've prepared for us today, O God. Thank you, Lord. As we learn today, Lord, may you speak to us. May you help us to learn new things, be encouraged by you, Lord, grow in you, Jehovah, Lord, and help even the society. We thank you, Jesus. We welcome you to teach today. In Jesus' name we pray and believe. Amen. Boys and girls, can you remember what you learned last week? Can you remember? Can you remember what you learned last week? Remind me. It was about the eagle. And we learned that the eagle is a master flyer. It is so good that it doesn't need to flap its wings. It just puts, spreads them out. The wind comes beneath the wings and it pushes the eagle higher and higher and higher. Remember what we said, that the wings of the eagle are so heavy that if it flaps them, the eagle uses so much energy that it could even die. Now, the eagle goes higher and higher and higher, higher than all the other birds, all the crows, all the chickens, all the doves, all the other birds, that it finds itself so much high up there that it is all alone. And it's looking down on all the other birds that are flying lower and lower, and even to the ground where the other buffaloes are, or the other rabbits are, all of the other animals. And sometimes even for us Christians, in our walk with Christ, you would feel that you're alone in what you do. For example, maybe you're in school, and the kids in your class decide to bully a child. But because you're a Christian, you can't go into that direction. Or for example, there is a test and you have to pass. Everybody else is cheating. But because you're a Christian, you choose to stay alone and to take the test. Even though you know that you might fail, but you choose to do the right thing. Being a Christian sometimes is not easy. Even in your family, maybe you're having a problem. Everybody else around you is worrying, but you're putting your trust in the Lord. All by yourself. It can be a lonely affair, being a Christian. And in the Bible, there's a story found in the book of Daniel, chapter 6, about a man who found himself alone, even when everybody else was doing things differently. Now, once there was a king called Darius. The king, who was called Darius, chose 120 rulers for his country. They were called satraps. So the rulers had three other people who were over them. And among them was a man of God. Now this man of God was excellent. Remember, he used to pray and he used to read the Bible. So he was excellent in what he was doing. He would not get to work late. He finished his assignments on time. He was not taking bribes. Generally, he was an excellent employee. And the king loved him very much. And because of that, he wanted to put him on top or over all the other satraps. And the people did not like that. They were like, we have to bring this man of God down. But when they looked at everything that he had done, remember, he was excellent in everything he did, they could not bring any charge against him to the king. So they sat and met together and thought, what shall we do? We need to bring this man of God down. And they went to the king and they told him, King, listen, write this law down. If anybody worships any other god except you, they shall be thrown to the lion's den. And the king must have sat there and thought, people will be coming to me, bowing their heads and raising their voices to me, asking me for everything, praising me, thanking me. That is not too bad. So he wrote a law and he said, if anybody worships anybody else except me, King Darius, we shall throw them to the lion's den. That is what happened. Now, the man of God heard this story. When he heard this story, he went to his room And he must have been very worried. He sat on his bed. You can imagine him sitting with his hands, on his head, and he's worrying, he's wondering, I am all alone. Everybody here is an idol worshiper. Remember what the Bible says in the commandments, worship no other God except me. So, and he was the only one who was a true worshiper because everybody else agreed we are going to be worshiping King Darius. So he must have sat and worried, what should I do? I am all alone. If I worship the king, I'll be going against our God. What should I do? And I can imagine that the Lord spoke to him and told him, I will never leave you. I will never forsake you. Even though you look alone, even though it sounds like you're all alone, remember, I will never leave you. I will never forsake you. Maybe that gave him courage because he went to his window. He opened it. It faced Jerusalem and he kneeled down and he raised his voice and he told God, thank you, Lord, for a good day. Thank you, Lord, that I'm still alive. And he prayed and he prayed and he prayed. Now, remember, there were guys who were after him. They wanted to take him down. So they must have been watching somewhere near the window. And they ran to the king and asked the king, King Darius, didn't you just put down a law that said if anybody worships any other god except you, they should be thrown into the lion's den? And the king said, yes. And then they told him, now, the man of God has been worshiping Jehovah. He's been worshiping Jehovah. We saw him. He was kneeling at the window, raising his voice up and praying to Jehovah. And the king was so distressed. But remember, he had written down the law that if anybody worships any other god except me, they shall be thrown into the lion's den. So there was nothing that could be done. The law had to be followed. So they took the man of God and they threw him into the lion's den and they closed the door of the den with a heavy stone. Now the king went home that evening and he was so, so sad. One of his best employees had been thrown into the lion's den and he could not have helped him. And there was a celebration that evening and the king did not even celebrate. He was not even able to eat. He was so, so sad. In the morning, when morning came, the king rose, King Darius, he rose and he went to the lion's den. And he shouted with a loud voice, servant of God, was the Lord that you serve able to protect you from the lions? And he waited and he heard a voice. The man of God was alive. The lions had not eaten him. He didn't even have a scratch on him. The man of God said, yes. God sent two angels and they protected me from the lion. And the king was so happy. He got the man of God out of the lion's den and there was much celebration. And the evil people who had set the man of God up, they were all thrown into the lion's den. Themselves, their wives, and their children, all thrown into the lion's den. And the Bible says, before they could even hit the floor of the den, the lions had broken up their pieces. So the lion had a feast with these evil men who decided to torment the man of God. Now, children, I want you to guess what the name of this man of God was. I'm sure you know. What was the name of the man of God? You're right. His name was Daniel. And God rescued him. Even though he was alone in serving the Lord rescued him. You may be in that situation at school where you, because you're a Christian, you find that you do not even belong. The kids do not want to play with you. You're not in a certain, the group of popular children, you're not there. You know, you eat alone, but do not forget that the Lord will always be with you. Though that you may feel alone, the Lord will always be with you. Now, to our memory verse of the day, it comes from the book of Isaiah, chapter 40 and verse 31. And the book of Isaiah is in the Old Testament. Remember, the Bible is the true word of God. Everything written in the Bible is true. So I will read for you the memory verse. It says, those who wait on the Lord, Isaiah chapter 40, verse 31, those who wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. Isaiah chapter 40, 31, it says, those who wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. So what that means is that those who wait on the Lord are those who believe in God, those who trust in God. It means that God will strengthen you. God will take you through the situation that you're going through. So if you put your trust in God and there is a situation in your life, maybe your grades are bad, maybe your parents have lost a job or a house, or maybe you need new friends, the Lord will help you through that situation. Now, promise me this week that you're going to be an eagle for the Lord. Put your trust in the Lord and He will help you through the difficult situation in your life. Shall we pray? Put your hands together, close your eyes. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, we thank you. Thank you for your promises are true. You tell us that those who trust in you, O Jehovah Lord, those who believe in you, God, they shall mount up with wings like eagles, O God. Lord, I pray that these children will remember that this week, that when they put their trust in you, God, in whatever issues that they are going through, that they're going to help them out. God, see them through this week, see them through this year. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray and believe. Amen. And now, to give to the Lord, we will use M-Pesa. And we use the Lipa and M-Pesa. The account number is 593035. And the Lord will bless you. Thank you and bye-bye.